Hello again, this is LaZouche Custom Shop here. Okay, this is one of my ongoing series of hints and tips, problems and fixes and so forth, series of videos to do with the Tokyo Marine 1911s, high cappers and associated pistols. And as you can see, this particular episode is about mainspring housings of various types. Now I'm going to go through the ones that I've used, i.e. upgrade ones, such as TSC, Garda, LCT, Nova and Tanya Koba, plus the standard Marui ones. They're all good, they all work exceptionally well. I've not found any of the upgrade ones that don't work that well, other than the TSC ones, which, well, I'll come to that in a minute. They can be a bit temperamental, but other than that they all work pretty well. Okay, first things first, your standard TM ones, which are your standard arched mainspring housing. As you can see, it's rounded. Yeah, very good piece of kit, it works. Never had any problems with them. As you can see, the spring inside there is held in by a small brass pin that goes in the side there. The actual real steel one, if you see actually on the moulding, there's a little dot there, I don't know if you can see it, but on a real steel there's a pin that goes through that holds the mainspring in, but obviously for airsoft ones they've done it on the side for ease. I suppose it's for ease, I suppose. Another version is the one that comes with the MEU. This has got serrations on it instead of the checkering like you see on the arched mainspring housing. Exactly the same design otherwise, no different. As I say, never had any problems with them. There are two different types, however. The one that comes with the high capper, this one, by the way, has been customised by me, but it's off of a 4.3. As you can see, it's got the built-in lanyard loop. But I've customised it, I've ground it down and given it golf balling designed grip. I think this was used on my Ed Brown Special Forces pistol, which unfortunately is, has gone the way of a lot of my pistols and been stripped down on the parts used elsewhere. Anyway, I digress. Coming back to the two different types, as you can see, at least I hope you can see, there is two different designs on either side of the mainspring housing. This one is for the 1911s and the MEUs, this one is for the high cappers. Now the high cappers purely have this bar running up the side, whereas the single stack TM pistols have this cutout. Now, you can retrofit the high capper ones to a standard 1911 or MEU frame by simply on the frame inside, the bottom of the frame, is cutting off the small slot piece that goes down into there, the small nub that sticks out that goes into there. You can just cut it off. I've done it myself, but I mean, you don't have to. There are aftermarket mainspring housings out there, which I'll come to in a minute, which means you don't have to use the high capper one now. But at the time there wasn't that many out there and I didn't have a lot of money, so I utilised the high capper on a single stack frame. Vice versa, you can use these in a high capper frame, however, without any remedial work, they will fit. The only problem is, and I'll swap it over so you can see the other side, is the fact that on a high capper this bar is longer, whereas that bar is shorter, it's on both sides. Which means that when this goes into the frame, when you get all the weight of the hammer strut coming down on the mainspring, it has a tendency to push that out from the back of the frame, which doesn't notice that much, but you can see it, let's put it that way. So there's more stress on this area than what there is on the standard high capper one. So if you are going to swap them over and use one of these on a high capper, yes, you can use it, there's no problems, but it will have more stress on it. So just a little tip there for you. Okay, so they're the basics, basic TM ones, which pretty much all of the other manufacturers such as KJW, Army, Tersel, Bell, even WE, they all pretty much go to those designs. They don't sort of change that much. In fact, WE mainspring housings can be swapped between the TMs and WE, and vice versa. The only problem is on single stack frame pistols, you cannot use the WE one purely because it's based on the high capper. That's where WE based all of their parts on the high capper frame, which means that when it comes to using them on single stack TM frames, you can't. That's the difference. They based all of their sizes on the high capper framed pistols, so that's why they won't work. Yeah, their single stack lower frames are totally different. Anyway, I'm digressing again. Okay, springs. As you can see, these are all of the main springs. Now, these two springs came in standard TM mainspring housings. As you can see, one's slightly shorter than the other. And in fact, one, if it was fully uncoiled, would be a hell of a lot longer than that. I think the main reason is the fact that Tokyo Marine subcontract out a lot of their parts, and that's why the different manufacturers, they just cut the springs off wherever they want. Doesn't really make that much difference. Obviously, this short one here, yeah, it might have a slight bit of difference on your hammer strut and your hammer engagement, i.e. when it flips across and engages with the knocker valve, but it's hardly anything, so I wouldn't really worry about it too much. This is the plastic cup, as they call it, which goes and sits in the top of the spring, which is, if you look at this one, I don't know if you can see it, but it's down in there, and that's what's held in by the little brass bit on the side. By the way, to get these out, it's dead simple. All you do is you just push down, and as you're pushing down with your screwdriver, you push up, which pops that out. So if I show you, there you go. You see that? It just pops that out to the side. See that? I don't know if you can make it out. There you go. So that's popped out, and the spring just comes straight out. There you go. There's the cup. All right, and vice versa. You want to put it back in, all you do is push down, drop it back in, and it's locked in. All right? So it's dead easy to get in and out. There's no problems there at all. Unless you're going to use an upgraded hammer spring. Now, these ones, I've mentioned them before. They're by King Arms. They're very, very good. Well, the recoil springs are anyway. But they throw in with it a hammer spring, which is good. I mean, it's good value for money. But they're 150% ones, these are. I think they do lesser grade ones, and maybe even higher grade ones, I'm not sure. But I always stick with 150% for the recoil springs. It seems to be a percentage that works. But of course, their hammer springs are going to be the same. I've found no use whatsoever for a hammer spring. I really haven't. I've always stuck with Tokyo Marine ones, the standard ones, and they worked fine. I know a lot of you guys out there who do race guns, high cappers and so forth, with high flow valves and whatever, and you find that the upgraded hammer springs work better. Yeah, they may do. For me personally, for skirmishing pistols, I can't find the use for them, really, to be quite honest. But anyway, that's how I look on it. So I find them surplus to requirements, to be quite honest. Okay, so that's your springs. Now then, when it comes to aftermarket parts, as I said earlier, there are various different brands out there. There's Garda, TSC, Nova, LCT, I even think Nineball do one actually as well, but I'm not sure on that. They're all very, very good. Nova and LCT and Garda, exceptionally good for their mainspring housings, very, very good indeed. TSC, on the other hand, cheap, cheerful, do the job. Let's put it this way, they're near enough half the price of a Nova extended magwell mainspring housing, as you can see. And you have the option of you can remove it and just have the mainspring housing, or you can have it attached because it's fitted with two little screws. So it is a very good design, actually. It does work. The only problem is if I show you a minute, is the mainspring pin hole that goes through into the frame. You have to knock your pin through, which is the pin there on the bottom of your frame. That goes through there. Now, I've had two of these TSCs, one silver, one black. and every time I've had to grind that hole out a considerable amount to get it to blooming fit. So they're never ever manufactured correctly. I've had two now and they've both been the same. So it's their poor manufacturing. That's why they're cheap. But all you have to do is get a needle file and just grind it out, whatever, file it out, and it works fine. Just be careful when you're knocking the pin through into a plastic framed gun, because they can distort and they can obviously bust the other side of the frame out if you're not careful, which I nearly did when I tried to fit one of these originally, thinking the hole was in the right place, and it wasn't. So yeah, so be careful with the TSC ones. The other thing actually that I want to mention as well, which I'll demonstrate on this. This is an oval one, by the way. I'll come to that in a minute. See the gap here between your beaver tail grip safety and the top of your mainspring? That's pretty much how the gap should be. Now when you put the TSC one in, I don't know if this can actually illustrate it, but as you can see, it's quite a bit lower. In fact, there was a huge gap between the top of this and the underside of the beaver tail when I originally had this fitted to this gun. This is my Street Kings gun, by the way. I've since fitted the proper Nova magwell to it. Yeah, so as I say, the gap, these are slightly undersized, so if you do get the TSC ones, you'll have that problem as well. They are slightly undersized, which is annoying, but they work. I mean, the grip safety still held, it all still worked. It's just that it's a bit unsightly and doesn't exactly look that good, but they're cheap, so you know, you pay your money, you get your choice. So that's as simple as that. The Garda ones, on the other hand, oh, and by the way, the fitment for the spring and everything is exactly the same as the Marui, i.e. you've got that little pin, as I spoke about on the side there, the little brass pin. All you do is you swap all of those parts over into your TSC one. It works exactly the same, no different. Same with the Garda. These are exceptionally good. Heavy, weighty bits of material. They're well machined, very clean, no flash, no markings, no mould lines, nothing like that. These are actually CNC machined and they're exceptionally good. Yeah, I cannot, I can't say anything bad about these at all. They are very, very good indeed. Actually, this illustrates a bit better the point I was making on the other ones, which in the real steel, you've got this little pinhole there, which real steel ones have. They have the pin going through, which holds the mainspring in. But again, Garda have gone with the Marui design of having a little plug hole there, which holds the spring in. So all you do is you swap your parts over from your standard Marui one straight into a Garda. The lanyard loop can be removed. There's a little screw there, so you can undo the screw and just pop him straight out, which is handy. Same as the Marui ones, exactly the same. So they're very, very good. Now then, when it comes to the Tanyakoba ones, their fitment is exactly the same, no difference at all. You just swap the parts straight out of your Marui ones straight into these, using the same fitting plug that goes in the top there. The only problem with these Tanyakoba ones that come with the safety parts set is the fact that they have done away with the screw on the side there. Crunch goes on the floor. If you take the Marui ones, now the Marui ones have got a tiny screw which holds the lanyard loop in. Same with the arched mainspring one as well, that's identical. For some reason, Tanyakoba have pinched in a piece of brass rod, which you just cannot get out unless you drill it out. And if you drill it out, well, you can never have your lanyard loop back in there again. So take care when you're buying the Tanyakoba parts set. Other than that, it's a very good little mainspring housing. It works exceptionally well. It's very, very good. It's very heavy, same as the Garda one. So yeah, it's very, very good, other than that. But again, the Tanyakoba one is quite cheap because you get it as part of the parts set. So they're good, but you pays your money, you takes your choice. So that one's got that small failing with it. Now when it comes to the LCT one, which are identical to Nova, LCT and Nova, they're one in the same. There's no real difference. Their machining is identical. It's very, very clean. CNC machined or laser cut, I would have thought. It's so, so clean. And they do identical series of mainspring housings. They do the checkered ones, they do the serrated ones, they do the ones with the magwells on, they do the LA Vickers type with a different kind of magwell. They do all sorts. And LCT do the identical same ones, so pretty much. So, yeah, very, very good. But these are expensive. LCT, not so much. They're like the cheaper version of the Nova. They're trying to undercut Nova, I think. They're doing a good job as well, but anyway. But these are slightly different to the standard Garda and Tokyo Marui ones, in the fact that you may have noticed there is no little hole on the side for that plug to go in to hold the spring in. So how do you do it? Well, that's where the real steel design comes in. They use a pin. See this little pin there? That pin, you get your spring in there, you hold it in position, and this is where it gets awkward. You slot the pin in, which is very, very tight, and you hammer it. You're best hammering it from the back outwards. I don't hammer it onto there, because if you miss it and hit the checker, and you'll damage it. So always hammer the pin in from the back. Once you hammered it in, it locks in place and your spring cup and spring won't come out. So it works, but it's more like the real steel than anything else. I think they've purely done it to be, more like the real steel. But other than that, yeah, it's there's no real big deal about it. But they are exceptionally tight pins to get in. They're really, really awkward to get in. So as I say, always hammer them in from the rear of the mainspring housing. So if you miss it and hit the mainspring housing with your hammer or whatever, it'll only damage the back of it, which is unseen. So you won't see it. The good thing, however, is LCT, I'm not sure about Nova, but I know LCT put a tiny little grub screw in so that you can remove the lanyard loop, which is handy. So you just undo the grub screw, lanyard loop just pops straight out. So really, really handy that. And I believe Nova are identical, because as I say, they're pretty much the same mouldings. Now the only Nova one that I've ever bought, which was second hand, funnily enough, but from a good friend of mine. Thank you very much, Chris. is the Magwell, extended Magwell version. It's the Smith & Alexander designed one. I purely wanted one of these to fit to my Street Kings pistol, because it is the identical one that's fitted to the one in the film. It's exceptionally good, very, very wide opening on it, which is slightly better than the TSC one. As you can see, the TSC one is a bit narrower, whereas this is wide, it's well built, it's robust, it's not going to fall apart. If you hit it, drop it, smack it, whatever, it's not going to bend. It's made out of good, solid steel. Steel construction. It's very, very good. Identical to the LCT ones. They're very, very good indeed. So yeah, I recommend it. And the fixing is identical with the small pin as the LCT. But if you want to remove, if you do get a standard one without the magwell on, and if you've got a lanyard loop on, whatever, you can remove it, because they've got the screw on the inside as well. So you don't have to worry about that. The only thing is with these S&A or Smith & Alexander designed magwell ones is you cannot remove the flared magwell off of the mainspring housing. It's fixed, so you can't remove it. That's the only problem with the Nova ones. You cannot unscrew them. Nova do two different types of extended magwell. They do the Smith & Alexander one and they do the LA Vickers one, both in either stainless steel or black like this one. But funnily enough, if you've seen the latest pistol by Tokyo Marui, they do the LA Vickers version on their Strike Warrior. If you have a look at their Strike Warrior pistol, it's got a flared magwell or extended magwell on the base of it. The design is identical to the Nova LA Vickers type. So instead of paying out a terrific amount of money for the Nova one, you've got one on your Strike Warrior. So, you know, if you do need an additional LA Vickers extended magwell, whatever, flared magwell, I wouldn't bother getting the Nova one. I would contact one of your local airsoft suppliers, whatever, who supply parts, and see if you can get a TM replacement magwell for a Strike Warrior. And it should fit. And it should be an identical design to the LA Vickers version. Okay, so that's just another little bit of info there for you. There's nothing, as I say, that can really go wrong with mainspring housings. The only thing is the springs can get tired, and as recently I had someone query this, which I may as well go for it now for you guys, is when the hammer comes back and cocks like that, as you can see, there's a little bit of play there anyway, which is like that, it should have play there. And as the slide comes back, it goes underneath the blowback housing, as you can see, just under there. Well, sometimes that hammer will catch on that back section there, this piece here. It will catch on it, and it will stop like that, and your slide won't go forward. Well, that can be actually one of three things. It can either be your mainspring in here is getting tired, i.e. it's been compressed, you've left it in the cocked position for too long, maybe you've put it away that way or whatever, left it for a month, come back, got it out and not worried about it, and then suddenly that starts happening. It's because either that spring is tired, i.e. it's been compressed too much, or the other thing is the sear up inside is worn so that the hammer isn't fully going all the way down to its notch that allows it to clear the blowback housing. It is meant to do that under the blowback housing, i.e. it does move a bit when the blowback housing runs across it. But if it's, you know, up too far when the sear and the hammer are worn, then it won't allow it to clear. The other reason why there might be problems if it's sticking back there is your recoil spring is tired. That's when it pays to get an upgraded one like that. Or just get your ordinary old recoil spring out, take it out of the pistol, and as I've said on a previous hints and tips video and on others, is grab the middle of the, actually if I show you on this one, grab the middle, that section there of the spring, and gently pull it out. Not a lot, just a little bit. Just gently uncoil those coils a bit more. But not the ends, leave the ends where they are. Just uncoil the middle section. That will revitalize tired old recoil springs for a little while longer, but once they start losing their tension, then you're pretty much better off getting a replacement. So as I say, the King Arms ones are very good, and they're cheap as well. So, but revitalize your spring first before you go out and buy a new one and see how it goes. It may last another year or so. Who knows? A lot of mine have. With the standard Bury springs. So there you go. Just a little bit of hint and tip there on how to save money and how to overcome the hammer going down and jamming under the blowback housing. Okay, so that's that. Now then, moving on to customization of mainspring housings. Now, I know a lot of you guys out there might not have the facilities to customize, you might not have large files or a Dremel or whatever, so you're lumbered with just having the aftermarket ones. And there's a good selection, as I say, Nova LCT, Garda. I mean, Garda are pretty much, I think they only do about two different designs, whereas LCT and Nova do absolutely endless designs. I mean, there's every single mainspring housing out there that you could think of. Both these companies do them pretty much. So you're okay. If like me, you're tight, no, if like me, you like to save a bit of cash, then instead of paying out something like $74 for an arched mainspring housing which has got serrations on it, i.e. lines down instead of the checkering, I think actually it might even be more than that now, I'm not sure, it might be $76 or $78 now, but they were rather expensive. What I do, that's the Nova ones by the way, what I did is I ground off the checkering, did away with it, polished it up, and got a hacksaw, and as you can, well, I hope you can see, I cut in, using a hacksaw, the lines into the mainspring housing. Dead simple to do, just be a bit careful that you make sure that you keep the saw dead in line when you're doing it. How I did it was I marked in white, I segmented at the bottom, so that as I was sawing across, I followed the white line, or a pencil line, whatever shows up good, then just follow that line very carefully and gently start going with it, and then you'll get the lines down it like that. You don't have to go in so deep, just as I say, they're not very deep, they're only about a mil deep. Then all you do then is spray it with undercoat, spray it black again, or silver, whatever, if you want it silvered, and Bob's your uncle. You've got a type or a series 70 Colt serrated arched mainspring housing. So simple little custom job, easy to do. This is a spare that I made. I did two of them. One is actually fitted on my Ed Brown Jim Wilson special signature edition, and yeah, it works fine. Never had any problems with him, so there you go. Another thing, if you notice, I mean, remember, this is just a checkered mainspring housing, standard TM one, no different. If you notice, there's no lanyard loop, and there's no holes. All I did was took the lanyard loop out, filled the holes in using my trusty MMD filler, as I always do, filled the holes in, sanded it down, and when I sprayed it, there you go, you've got no holes on there, so it's flush. Simple, cheap little way to create a custom mainspring housing. Now, when either of these, whether it's the MEU with the serrations in or the arched one with the checkering in, you can do any number of different designs to it, especially the arched one, because you've got more there to work with. As you can see, this one here is same as the MEU one, i.e. it's a flush one, it's a flat, not arched. It's actually originally an arched one, but I ground them all off, polished it up, sanded it and whatever. I think it went down to grade 120 sandpaper, because you want a key if you're going to spray it. So sprayed it with undercoat and then sprayed it with black over the top, and Bob's your uncle, you've got a generation 1 or a 1911 style flush mainspring housing. So if you're thinking of doing a classic 1911 look, i.e. pre-Second World War, then that's the way to go. As I say, simple. And no aftermarket manufacturer does a flush mainspring housing. None of them. Not Garda, not LCT, not Nova, not TSC. None of them do them. So that is a custom job that is, well, yeah, it is a custom job, a one-off job. So if you're thinking of doing a retro 1911, then that's the way to go, because you cannot get it as an aftermarket part. Now, as I explained earlier on, you can do the same to the high kappa mainspring housings. The only problem is, if you're going to fit them to, as I said, to a single stack 1911 frame, you'll have to cut the slot inside the frame off to get these to fit, or machine out into them for the slot to fit in, which is going to be more awkward. I would just cut it off on the frame. The other thing you might have to do as well is to shorten this bar down that's on the side there, that bar there. You'll just have to shorten that down, because the bar on the side of the standard TM one, as I explained earlier on, is shorter. So you need to shorten that down. But you can use these to customise. As I say, I did the golf ball in on there, and it's a lot easier as well because they're plastic. So for filing down, whatever, dead easy, no problems at all. So yeah, you can use them for customising as well. Now, you can also have endless fun doing whatever designs you want. I did like a fishtail, fantail design, whatever, to this one. I even cut a small V in this, just to show the workings of the hammer strut as it goes down inside. It didn't interfere with the beaver tail grip safety, because it's not wide enough to stop that working. Besides, the beaver tail is actually held in up here somewhere, not so much down at the bottom. I always thought that it needed that to rest against, but no, it doesn't. Anyway, I digress. So as I say, that's a design I did. Never actually used it on a pistol yet. It was going to be for some outlandish race gun design I was going to do on a single stack, but I never got round to doing it in the end. It was going to be like a sort of a an Indian chief type motif on a 1911, so that's why I did like the fantail. It was going to have all embellishments all over it, but I never got round to it in the end, so it was shelved. But as I say, you can come up with whatever designs you want. All this was just sanded off exactly the same as I did with the smooth mainspring housing. But then I cut in using a hacksaw these lines, then cut down the middle with a hacksaw, and then filed it and whatever, and it just gave me that design. But as I say, you can do any endless numbers of designs. You know, as long as you've got hacksaw and files and whatever, then yeah, the world's your oyster. You can do whatever you want with them. Okay, so that's, as I say, that is pretty much it. There's not much else that you can that can go wrong on a mainspring housing. The only other thing, as I said earlier on, with regards to fitting the TSC ones, is when you're knocking the pin through on the frames, especially plastic frames, make sure that when that pin goes through, that this side of the frame isn't bowing out as you're knocking from this side. So check as you're tapping it through. Because if it is starting to bow out, then it means that the actual hole that's drilled through the mainspring housing, whatever, is out of alignment. And it's pushing the frame out, which means that you've got to take that back out, take the pin out, and grind out the hole so that it will fit properly. But don't grind out too much, because if you do, the pin won't hold. It'll just drop straight through. So be careful. So it's a bit of a tricky job to do, but I mean, as I say, I've only ever had any problems with the TSC ones, so Garda, LCT, Novas, whatever, they should fit fine, so you shouldn't have any problems at all with those. But just in case you go to fit the TSC ones, be careful. And that's pretty much it. So as I say, hopefully these hints and tips will help you guys out there. With regards to cost, Nova's the most expensive. LCT and Garda, pretty much vie for the same position. Maybe a bit cheaper for the Garda ones. Exceptionally good quality for all three of those. Really, really good. Tanya Cobra come alongside Garda, but their quality's a little bit, well, hit and miss. These are MIM parts, i.e. metal injection moulded, whereas Nova, LCT and Garda are actually CNC machined, and you can tell by the weight. But all that Tanya Cobra have done is added lead to their MIM parts just to give them weight. But they're cheap, cheaply made, but they can charge a bit more because, as I say, you get those in with the parts set. So I should imagine separately it would be a lot cheaper than these others. But when they come with a part set, they're pretty much equal price to the rest, maybe a bit more, obviously. But you do get a lot more in the part set, so because you get a thumb safety and loads of other bits. Anyway, so as I say, Tanya Cobra ones, yeah, cheaply made, and you cannot remove the lanyard loop without drilling out that little pin. So it's a pain in the arse, that is, but there you go. Not that I like lanyard loops, I can't stand them, but there you are. I only ever have those on retro or the older versions of 1911s. I can't see the point of them on new ones. None of the modern manufacturers actually fit them now, I don't think. Or if they do, it's hardly ever. Most of the custom pistol jobs that I've done don't have a lanyard loop, so there you go. Anyway, I mean, they are handy, don't get me wrong, if you drop your pistol or whatever, it's handy to have it trailing behind you or whatever. At least you won't lose it. But I've taken a tip of not taking a pistol down into the woods with me when I do my woodland games, because you're guaranteed to lose it. So there you go. I've not personally lost a pistol, but one of my friends has lost one, and it was a silver blooming pistol, so you'd think it'd stand out in the undergrowth. No, it didn't. So, and it was a Western Arms, I believe, so it was quite a costly loss for him. So there you go. So just another little tip there for if you're skirmishing or whatever, don't bother taking a pistol with you. Or at least it doesn't work on my site. I don't bother taking a pistol. I just rely on my AEG. Anyway, that's a side note. I'm digressing again. So as I say, there's no other things that can really go wrong with these mainspring housings. They're reliable. The only thing is the spring, which, as I've gone over previously. TSCs are the cheapest of the bunch. They're good. They work. But they need a little bit of tidying up here and there. I would suggest that when you fit the screws and fit the magwell itself to the base of the mainspring housing, that you use a thread Loctite. I use this stuff, which is Bond Lock, but I mean, there's loads out there. There's thread lock, which is Loctite's own version. Loads of different types. Just put a bit of thread lock onto the screws so that when you screw them in, you aren't halfway through a game and you look around, where's me magwell gone? Because they will vibrate and fall out because they're smacked into by the top of your magazines. Every time you slam one home, you hit either side of that, so they will eventually get loose. So, yep, grip thread the screws in, you'll be fine. Doesn't matter with the Nova ones because, as I say, they can't be removed. They're part and parcel of the mainspring itself, mainspring housing, that is, itself. Okay, so there you go. Hopefully those hints and tips will help you guys out, save you a bit of cash, and all I can say is happy customising. Okay, this is LaZouche Custom Shop, signing off.